Hello everyone and welcome to this video. Now today I'm going to be doing a vinyl update video. So it has been quite a while since I last done one. I believe this is my first one of the year. So I have amassed a fair few records, like not like too many, like it's not any more than I would normally have like for like a vinyl update. Yeah, I said simply because I haven't been buying as much lately, and I've not really had much of the chance, like thanks to like the lockdowns and that. And then even then, I've not really been buying too much online anyway. So some of this stuff goes back to actually like the end of like 2020, like as well. So yeah, I will just get right into the video. So I'm gonna kind of go like chronologically speaking, usually in these videos I tend to build up to sort of like the kind of like the high ticket sort of grail item sort of thing. Like I haven't really got any off those, so I'm just gonna kind of go sort of like chronologically, from when I bought the albums. So I'll just start with a couple what I bought in Edinburgh. Again, this was I think back at the end of 2020. So these just for various Edinburgh record shops. We'll just start off with a classic album here, which I didn't own, Bob Dylan's Highway 61 Revisited, and then 1965 album here. This is, I would probably say, my favourite Dylan album. There's a lot of good material, like audio things like a Rolling Stone, and Desolation Row is fantastic as well. So yeah, like a lot of my favorite Dylan songs I could on here. So yeah, for me, like one of his strongest albums. And then I also picked up this one here, ABBA the Singles. Now I was kind of missing a sort of like a really good like ABBA hits compilation. I know sort of like the go-to one like is like ABBA Gold, but this one is pretty good for me because it has maybe my favorite ABBA song on it, The Day Before You Came. That's what made this one like worth picking up. Only slight disappointing thing with this was I believe it's missing one of the unique inner sleeves. Both of the inner sleeves are this sort of design, whereas like they had sort of like whereas like the original one like had different designs like on them. But like anyway, still a great record here, ABBA the Singles. Okay, now this one was a bit of a blind buy. I'd heard off the band, however, I didn't really know sort of like what style like of music like it was. It's a band called Clover. Now, how I heard this name was these were the guys who played on Elvis Costello's debut album, My Aim Is True. And I love that record. I think the musicianship on it is absolutely top-notch. And like knew that like these guys like were like the people like you like played with it. So I bought this album, and again I think I listened to it once again back at like the tail end like of 2020, so I can't really remember too much of it. I don't think I maybe thought too much of it, because otherwise I probably would have like played it a bit more, like, or maybe tried to like investigate the band a bit more. But what I do know is that these guys later became Huey Lewis and the News. I think he was with them. I've just seen the name there, like Huey Lewis, but I said I'm not a massive fan of his either. But yeah, this is Clover from I think the mid 70s, this one here called Unavailable. Now I really wanted to get another album by this artist, but this is still a great record though. It's Joe Jackson's Night and Day. But the one I really want to get, and like still haven't got my hands on, is Look Sharp. I think that was his debut album. And yeah, it's just a bit more sort of like that sort of new wave, that sort of like feel to it, a bit more sort of like Elvis Costello, that like, sort of vibe to it. This one is using a lot more synthesizers and more sort of jazzy sort of like influence on it, but it's still a great record though. 1983 this one, and like 82 sorry this one here. So yeah, Joe Jackson and Night and Day. I think I got these ones from another shop now, two 12 inch singles which I didn't have, from a couple of my favorite artists. So this one is ELO. This is for the song Four Little Diamonds, a single from the Secret Messages album, a bit of a flop single, but this one has on the backs of it you've got Letter from Spain, which is probably the worst song of the Secret Messages, and then a track called The Bouncer, which is a unreleased B-side. I think it's on the Time, I think it's a bonus track now, like on Time CDs, like the like CDs like of that album. But yeah, certainly like a exclusive vinyl B-side there for ELO. And then we've also got this one here, which is by Morrissey. This is his first single, Suede Head, so quite an important single here. And again, some great B-sides on it. We've got a song called I Know Very Well How I Got My Name, and then also the fantastic Hairdresser on Fire is on here as well. So great single here from Morrissey, his first his first solo release in 1988.
Next few, again, are all 12-inch singles, which I got from a site called VinylNet,
which is a website which is kind of like a collective of different record record shops from around the country. And one of my favourite shops used to be part of it. It was called Unknown Pleasures, in Edinburgh. However, sadly, that shop closed down, I think, in the summer of last year. A real loss, the city's record shops and that. There's very few remaining, in Edinburgh now. But I did buy these from effectively their online store sort of thing, what they now operate. I will just show them now. So I got two 7-inch singles here, a little matching set. Both are Lloyd Cole singles, and both are from his Bad Vibes album. So we've got Morning Is Broken and So You'd Like to Save the World here. Again, two singles I've never seen in the wild before. Again, both have exclusive B-sides, I believe. And both are very nice. To be Lloyd Cole singles. And then sticking with Lloyd Cole, we've got this one, which is Lost Weekend, a classic single by The Commotions. It's got the extended version of it, which I really love, actually. I know a lot of people don't have much time for these sort of 12-inch mixes and that, but I quite like the 12-inch mix here of Lost Weekend. And then you've got two exclusive B-sides called Big World and Never Ends on here as well. So yeah, from their Easy Pieces album, that's Lloyd Cole and The Commotions. Next, now again, another one which I would probably never really see in the wild, and never really come across this artist's singles, but it's a Tom Petty one. It's from Running Down a Dream from Full Moon Fever album. And again, this has a nice exclusive B-side, a song called Down the Line, a track I think he co-wrote with Jeff Lynne, if I'm not mistaken. He was certainly working with Jeff a lot around this time. That's a nice Tom Petty single there for Running Down a Dream. Now, a couple of New Order singles. I believe I've shown these on my channel already in my top 10 New Order songs video, which I've done towards the start of this year. But as I said, it's been so long since the last final update, these haven't been featured in one. I got this one, which is for Shell Shock. One of my favourite New Order singles, actually, this one here. I think it's a rather underrated track. 1986, I want to say, on that one. And this one is Everything's Gone Green, which is their second single release. Again, one of my favourites. I always thought that this had the song Procession on the B-side. It turns out it doesn't. You've got songs called Mesh and Cries and Whispers on the B-side. So I'm not really sure where that Procession Procession song was released, if it was its own single, if it was a different version of this whatnot. Still a nice pickup here, New Order. And again, still from this online store, I got this Elvis Costello single. This is for The Other Side of Summer. This is from his Mighty Like a Rose album from 1992. So again, not something I've ever really come across in the wild before. All of these really cheap. They're all about I think the New Order ones maybe a fiver. This one, I think a couple of quid. A lovely Elvis Costello single there. And then again, I'm always on the hunt out for XTC singles or anything XTC related, what I haven't already got. And this is one of them. It's a Great Fire 12-inch single here from the Mama album. Maybe not one of my favourite XTC singles. I don't think it was a particularly strong choice as a single. It's a great song, but it was never going to be a huge commercial hit by any means. But this has a ton of B-sides on it. It's got a track called Gold, which is really good. And then a couple of more ambient things. A track called Frost Circus and then Procession Towards Learning Land, which were again I think kind of like and Andy Partridge sort of experimental recordings there. So yeah, a nice single here though, XTC and Great Fire. Now I also ordered this one here, Paul McCartney, this one. However, the problem was I already had this version of the single on the website they list the catalog numbers. However, it had a different catalog number on the listed one on the website. So when I got this, I was a bit disappointed. So I just fired off a wee quick email to them, just saying, they free of charge sent the correct one here. So this is the alternative. This one single. This as I said, it's just what happens when you got into the 90s, artists started releasing multiple versions off the same song, all with different B sides. And I said, this one has a track called Good Sign on it, which is exclusive to this single. I don't think it was even on like the archive version, like a Flowers in the Dirt. So yeah, this was a really nice one to pick up as well. Paul McCartney, this one. Okay, now I've got a couple of online purchases, sort of like a few like random tidbits here. This is a 7-inch single, what was released. I probably got this one more for like the novelty of it, kind of like who it was, like who was on it too. Again, two of my absolute favourites here. It's Morrissey and David Bowie. So this is them doing a cover of the T-Rex song Cosmic Dancer. And then also what made me get this one was on the B-side, you've got Morrissey doing a cover of The Jam's That's Entertainment. So again, all round, like a nice little purchase here. Like, yeah, Morrissey and David Bowie. This recorded sometime like in like the 90s, I think 94, 95, I want to say. And then I also picked up this CD. This was an eBay purchase. It's a copy of The Beautiful Side's Carry On Up The Charts. Now, I did already have this CD, overall, like, my family already owned this CD. It's a hugely popular release. It's estimated about, like, I think, like, 1 in 7 households, like, have a copy, like, of this album here. But what makes this one special is that it's a 2-disc version. So on the other CD, you've got a collection of B-sides and, like, unreleased tracks, which is really nice for me. Again, I'm a huge fan, like, of all things Paul Heaton and, yeah, I said, especially The Beautiful South, and it is great to get some of these tracks, things like But Till Then and Love Wars and like I Started a Joke, like some, yeah, really, really good quality material, like on like CD, like easily like accessible there. So yeah, and that's The Beautiful South, Carry On Up The Charts. This was another online purchase here. This is by Field Music, a band who I've really grown to love over the last maybe that year or so. Introduced to me by like Rob Walker, and I've been slowly collecting their albums. This is called Tons of Town, which I believe is their second album. This is a reissue of it though. I believe all their albums have been reissued, and they're all quite easy to come by. Maybe except for Measure. I think that one's maybe gone up like in value a little bit. But what makes this one quite nice is it's on a lovely yellow vinyl, which is pretty cool to see there. So yeah, a fantastic record here, definitely one worth checking out. And like if you're into sort of like clever, slightly quirky pop, yeah, that's Field Music, Tons of Town. Okay, now we're a bit more up to date now. This one, I believe I bought in HMV, maybe the first week like they reopened, like after, like, I mean, like they were shut up, they were closed like up here like for like a long while, like after Christmas. But I think I got this one maybe about April time, like when like they did start to reopen. And it's a Blur album. It's The Great Escape here. So this is Blur's fourth album, released kind of, I would say, like at like the peak of like the popularity, but kind of I think they kind of run their course a little bit with this sort of Britpop vibe and sound. I mean, there are some great tracks on here. I do love the two singles, Stereotypes and The Universal. But again, it's quite a long record, and there's maybe a little bit of filler creeping in here. But again, fantastic artwork, and again, Blur, a band I've really been getting into over the last month or so. Another one I think I bought in HMV, like if I'm not mistaken. Again, be really getting into this band, another 90s band, Teenage Fan Club, lately. So this is their album Songs from Northern Britain. So this is again, I'm not sure what number album this is, but came out 1997 originally, and again, a very fine album here. Maybe not quite as like well revered as maybe say Bandwagon-esque or like Grand Prix, but still a very good record though. Songs from Northern Britain. And again, now another artist I've been really getting into lately is the one and only Kate Bush. So I picked up this record, Hounds of Love, which is an amazing album, I have to say. Kate Bush had always been one of like these artists I'd always really passed over, sort of thing. I knew that like she was well liked, like in like the vinyl community, and well revered, like well beyond it. But I never really bothered with her too much. But certainly like this is a great album to start with, because it does have probably some of the biggest hits on it, like Running Up the Hill. Like I've always liked that song like since I first heard it. But then you've got some great tracks, like the title track itself, Hounds of Love, and then it was when I think I heard Cloud Busting like on like the radio, and I just loved all the cellos going on. So that again made me want to check out this album. And then you've got like the second side, which is this kind of suite of songs called The Ninth Wave, and it's yeah, just a fantastic, beautiful album here. The Hounds of Love, by the wonderful Kate Bush. And now this next one
was a reissue of an album, or rather the first time it's been issued like on vinyl actually. It's another Lloyd Cole one, and it's his album Antidepressant here. So this one came out originally, I believe, in the mid-2000s, I want to say 2007 sort of time, 2008 kind of thing. But yeah, this is a great record. It's a bit more, again, it's quite stripped back like a lot of his recent output has been. It has got like little touches off like the electronics, like which he would explore a little bit like on like later releases, like that of full on like ambient albums, but then also his latest one, Guesswork. But then it's also like just got some really great songwriting on it, and I do really rate this album, and I'm very glad to get it on vinyl. I believe that all the other Lloyd Cole albums that will be coming out on vinyl, they'll all be surefire pickups like for me. Nice to get a copy of Lloyd Cole's Antidepressant. Next tune I bought from Assisi Records in Edinburgh. Again, they more specialise in new music, this one. And like this shop, but like it's the kind of, for me, the go-to place, like if I am looking for like new vinyl or like records like what have maybe been issued like over like the last couple of years, because you can always get some great deals, and this one was certainly a case of that. This is by the DMAs, and this is their album For Now. Now the DMAs had one of my favorite records from last year, The Glow, fantastic records, and this one came out a couple of years before, 2018. But I'd never got around to pick it up, but I'm quite glad that like I did see it like in like a CC, because they only wanted like £10 for it, a brand new copy of it. So yeah, definitely hard to pick it up, and this is another great record for them. It's maybe not quite as good as The Glow for me. A lot of the songs do have a kind of similar vibe to them, but it's still a fantastic record. So yeah, that is the DMAs For Now. And then another one bought at CC Records was this, Field Music, which is their latest album. It's Flat White Moons. This one again came out around April or May sort of time. And this is a good record. I think this is a bit of a return to form for Field Music, because I wasn't a big fan of the last two albums really. And this one is slightly better. Some of my favourite songs of the year are Do Me a Favour and Out of the Frame are both fantastic, and then In the City is great as well, and there are a lot of fantastic tracks on here, so kind of like a return to form sort of thing, I think, for Field Music, for Flat White Moon. And then I've shown this before, like on my channel. I've done a full review like off this record soon after it came out, but I will just show it again in this video. It is Paul Weller's Fat Pop Volume 1 here. So yeah, great record. I won't go into detail like about this one. Just say it's probably going to be my album of the year. And then I also picked up the little CD box set off it as well. So yeah, that's Paul Weller Fat Pop. Okay, we're almost there. We're right up to date now. And these ones, these next few were bought when me and my girlfriend went to Carlisle for the day. They've got a couple of really good record shops there. Like, I'd never been to like either like off them. The first one was called Vinyl Cafe, and that was definitely the better like off like the two. It's quite big inside actually, and they did have a really good selection. They actually had a couple of House of Love albums, like which like I'd spent maybe like the last year so like looking for. Eventually ended up buying them like online, but then it turned out like, I mean, like I seen them all like in like this shop, but like anyway, I did buy a couple of things there. So I got these two singles. This is a Squeeze one. It's for Another Nail in My Heart, one of my favourite Squeeze songs, and it's really nice. You have to get like the picture sleeve for it as well, just with the band on it. And this is a Style Council single, which I believe I don't own. It's one, like, I remember like I bought a massive job lot of Style Council singles maybe about 2 or 3 years ago now, but I don't think this was one of them. It's a Groovin' single here, which is basically another name for You're the Best Thing, and then you've got Big Boss Groove on the B-side to it. So You're the Best Thing, one of their finest songs there. Another nicely single there from the Style Council. And then I also picked up this record here, which is Teenage Fan Club's album Endless Arcade. This is a brand new release as well, actually, like another one to add to my growing list. This is a good album here, I thought. This one, like I said, it got quite cheap, like in like that Vinyl Cafe, because it was already opened. I think it might be like an ex-demonstration one or something, but it's got the kind of die-cut cover to it, which is really cool.
And then this is on a lovely green vinyl as well, so worth showing that one there. The new album by Teenage Fan Club. And then we walked along like a little bit more. There was another record shop, and this one not quite as good. I maybe wouldn't go back to that one personally. But they did have a little offer on. You could get I think it was 3 12-inch singles for £5. So I kind of went through like the racks, and I did find three which I wanted to get. So that's what I done. So first one is an Aztec Camera one. This is for the song All I Need Is Everything, single version here, which is very nice. And then it also comes with a little poster as well, I believe, this one, which just has the lyrics on it there. So yeah, that was a nice one. Then I also got this one, which is by Big Country. So this is Fields of Fire. I'm a semi-big fan of Big Country. I'm not the biggest fan, but I do love this album, The Crossing. So I thought this was a worthy single to pick up. And then you've got a B-side, Angel Park, which I don't think was on the album, The Crossing either. So a nice single there, and like nice artwork to it as well. This one, a little bit more obscure, is by The Colourfield, song called Thinking of You. Now, The Colourfield were a band which Terry Hall from The Specials and Funboy 3 fronted in the mid-80s. They weren't particularly successful. This was probably like their biggest single, and I think it might have got to like the top 10. Like, I'm not too sure. But yeah, this is like a nice 12-inch single off it. Again, with a song called My Wild Flame on the B-side, which wasn't on like their Virgins and Philistines album. A nice one here to pick up by The Colourfield. Last three. Now, these were all bought in Glasgow when I went through there a couple of days ago. So these are from a shop called Mixed Up Records in the West End, like off the city. Fantastic record shop. I could have bought more, be honest, with you. But these were like the three that what like I came out with. I didn't want to spend too much. Okay, and next one is by The Cure. So this is Close to Me single here. Again, a classic song, 1985 this one came out, and again, only £8, so quite reasonably priced. You don't often come across like these sort of things like in like the wild. Again, it's a bit hard to read like what like the B-sides are to this one here. I think it's you've got a song called Man Inside My Mouth on the B-side, and that might be the only song on there. I'm not too sure, but as again, it's quite hard to make out what the actual full song titles are there. That's The Cure there from 1985. And last one for this video, you'll be glad to hear, is this album here. As I said, I've already shown a record by this artist previously. Been really getting into her, and I decided to pick up this one. So Kate Bush's album, The Dreaming. So this is one that came out, I believe, directly before Hounds of Love. It's a bit more experimental, and it was completely self-produced by Bush, and I kind of appreciate the artistry what went into this, but it is a bit more of a difficult listen, I would say. It certainly lacks a kind of commercial polish off Hands of Love, but still a great record though, and one which may grow on me a little bit more. But yeah, as you can see there, only £12 for a lovely original version, considering some of her records are pretty rare, pretty desirable items there. I'll just show the inner sleeve of this one, just the lyric sleeve, and then the record. Not sure what label she was on now. It was on, it's, I think it's on EMI Records, yeah. But yeah, a lovely copy there of The Dreaming by Kate Bush. So yeah, that's me come to the end of this vinyl update video. So I hope you have enjoyed, and yes, I will see you all next time for the next video. Goodbye.